Will be here in Georgia this weekend.
President Biden and former President Donald Trump, they both will hold rallies less than 100 miles apart from each other. Trump will be in Rome. The president will be in Atlanta. This marks the first visit either candidate has made to Georgia this election year. Atlanta News First political reporter Doug Reardon live tonight in Midtown.
And tomorrow's visit will come less than 48 hours after President Biden's fiery State of the Union address, Doug.
Right, absolutely. And Georgia took a very central role in that annual address. Immigration and the death of Lakin Riley on the UGA campus are sure to certainly be big elements of this campaign season, but will also very likely be a big piece of both of these candidates' messages to voters tomorrow.
Weeks after the death of Lakin Riley on the University of Georgia campus, President Joe Biden invoked the 22-year-old nursing student by name in his third State of the Union address. During a tense exchange with Georgia Congresswoman Marjorie Taylor Greene, Biden held up a button bearing Riley's name that Greene handed to him minutes earlier when he entered the House chamber.
Lakin Riley, an innocent young woman who was killed by an illegal. That's right. But how many of the thousands of people being killed by illegals? To her parents, I say, my heart goes out to you, having lost children myself.
Between calls to cap insulin costs, provide more funding for Ukraine, and craft federal protections for IVF and abortion rights, Biden also hammered Republicans for their refusal to support an existing border security bill, one his predecessor, former President Donald Trump, has urged members of the GOP not to vote for. Trump later responded on his site Truth Social, calling the speech the, quote, angriest, least compassionate, and worst State of the Union address ever.
Biden has actively aided and abetted the importation of millions and millions of illegal alien migrants.
The two rivals and likely 2024 contenders for the White House will hold dueling rallies in Georgia on Saturday, Trump in Greene's home district of Rome and Biden in Atlanta.
It just says that Georgia is an important state, and both campaigns want to win Georgia's Electoral College votes.
Kennesaw State University politics professor Ben Taylor says expect to see more frequent visits from Trump and Biden and their surrogates as the election cycle reaches a critical point.
And Riley's accused killer, 26-year-old Venezuelan national Jose Ibarra, entered the country illegally in 2022, authorities said. Georgia lawmakers here in the state have already passed legislation, or are considering legislation that would mandate the reporting of undocumented migrants inside Georgia jails. We're live in Midtown. Doug Reardon, Atlanta News First.